our top stories tonight, the news that the UK economy has grown again for the fifth quarter in a row. With me is Polly Toynbee of The Guardian newspaper and Adam Memon, head of economic research at the Centre for Policy Studies, a centre-right think tank co-founded by Lady Thatcher. It's great to have you both in. Thanks for joining us. Polly, if I could start with you. The little island of the cost of living crisis that Ed Miliband and Mr. Balls have been standing on, it's being eroded and eroded and eroded gradually by the fact that the economic statistics are suggesting that everything is getting better. Their argument is dying, isn't it?
It's not a little island, I'm afraid it's a very big one. What we're seeing is almost no change. When the car has stopped going backwards, that's the really good news. It's stopped getting worse. If you look at, they're talking about growth, they mean growth of the whole economy. If you look at growth per capita, it's practically stagnant. The whole economy has only got bigger because we've got more people.
But
what really matters,
we're just 0.6% below what the economy was.
But that's because there are more people. What people feel in their own pockets is how much is there per head. And the point is, because the population's got much bigger, a lot more immigration in just recent years, people individually haven't got any better. And what's more, this is an average. And you know what an average is? An average is a man with his head in the oven and his feet in the fridge who is, on average, just about right. For most people, for the great majority, they feel they've had no increase at all. Take away the bankers' bonuses and there is
all
no
right.
increase.
Okay, Adam, I know a lot of people who don't think everything is rosy in the garden economically, frankly.
It's true, it's a lot further to go, but real wages, we are being seen that. We see wages rising above inflation. I think
if you're lucky enough to get a bonus.
Maybe. But Polly, where are the bonuses coming from?
Bankers?
No, they're not. They're coming from manufacturing, 10.2%, and construction, 12.8%. What were the bonuses in finance, Polly? 1.1%. The bonuses are coming from manufacturing and construction. And if we're saying that wages are rising because of bonuses, I think that's a good thing. Because most people in industries across the country are getting them.
But you have to admit, the vast majority of people have not seen an increase that they would notice in any sense at all. Because, as you know, you'd agree that the point is, per capita GDP has hardly budged. You'd agree with that, wouldn't you?
But it's higher than the election. And what we're seeing now is increases in nominal wages, vacancies are rising across the country, and the inactivity rate is now the lowest since 1990. So this isn't just a cyclical thing. These are quite major changes which are taking place. It's not just a small-scale thing.
Full depends who you are. Of course, as ever, the people in the very top have done very well. The great majority of people have not seen any increase, and the bottom 20 to 30% are really in a bad way. The number, the increase, the numbers of people working part-time, we don't want to. The people on 0 hours.
Pre-tax income and post-tax income, the bottom 10% are better off now than they were at the last election. Partly due to rising disposable income, but also due to things like fuel duty, things like child tax credits.
But they don't have cars. The bottom 10% don't own cars. That's the trouble. You don't know about people at the bottom. The bottom 20% don't have cars. You keep adding things in that are averages that affect people much higher up. The people at the bottom have lost out time and time again on council tax, on just about everything, on their tax credits, on their housing benefits, in every way. The people in work, the majority of the very poor,
high employment.
Yeah, but they're in work, but they're not earning enough.
All right, but
they're no better off in work and poor.
Polly, that is a good point that Alan makes, isn't it? There are a lot more people in work, despite how crippling this recession's been, than in any other previous recession. People
it's a very good thing.
The CBI is now saying that business confidence is at a 41-year high. They're the people who create the jobs that will keep people in work and improve their standard of living.
Excellent.
That's a good thing.
Of course it is. The great thing about this recession is that many more people have stayed in work or got jobs. But the trouble is the work that they've got, which is likely to be the only work there is going to be far into the future, is very low paid, very marginal, insecure, temporary agency jobs. You know, even graduates,
half of graduates doing those kinds of jobs.
What we're not seeing is very much growth in the sorts of jobs that sustain a family. Right. All of these people need subsidies still from the taxpayer.
Right. The growth that we are seeing that is in the economy, it's fueled by a housing bubble. When it pops, we're all going to be screwed, aren't we?
That's not true. I'm afraid it's not true because, firstly, a lot of the, if you look at new people who have vacancies, these advertised salaries are higher than they were before, which suggests wages.
But there are a lot more people who are self-employed now than for a long, long time. time, and it's because they've had to set up their own businesses because there aren't any jobs out there.
Well,
they have to do that.
Some people. So you have seen quite a large increase in self-employment, but you have also seen quite a large increase in full-time
employees.
Zero-hour
contracts. Right in there. That's been problematic, hasn't it? And what is the coalition doing about that?
Well, zero-hour contracts work for some people. They don't work for other people. And of course, there does may need to be some reform of that. But for some people, it's quite easy. It's students, people who are looking
for
after...
For most people, it's a disaster because they never know whether they're going to work 3 hours work a week or 20 hours work a week. You can't budget. You can't bring up a family. It's a disaster.
Well,
a few
work
people
like that.
Like
for some people,
yes, but for very few. Most people need to know what they learn every week and how they're going to support their family.
And this isn't just a housing boom, sorry, because we are seeing the services growing. The services sector was by far the most important part of the growth in the last quarter.
But
manufacturing.
And they're the low-wage jobs. The low-paid, briefly, Polly,
before we come to an end here, what does Ed Miliband, how does he respond to these increasing number of figures that are suggesting the economy is doing well? How does he deal with that as an election
strategy? If you hard facts, you look at what the Institute for Fiscal Studies says, which tends to be the judge in these matters, who says virtually nobody, except the very top, a couple of percent, will be any better off at the next election. And a very large number of people won't be better off until, right till the following election. This has been the deepest, darkest recession, and there's no doubt it's been much worse by the kind of austerity that's been imposed.